May I now request Dean R&D to kindly tell us about the sponsored and consultancy projects.
Thank you, Professor Patak. And also, good morning and welcome to all teachers, co-teachers. I am also a teacher like you. And my name is Balaji. I'm a faculty in the Department of Bioscience and Bioengineering for several years now, and as well as the Dean of Research and Development for this institute. What I would like to do is to sort of take this opportunity to tell you about some of the research and development activities that go on in our institute. I'm not sure how many of you are aware of this, but our institute currently has about 10,000 students, of which only about 3,600 are admitted through the joint entrance examination, which is widely known. And about 6,000 to 6,500 students are master's and PhD students. Why am I telling this? Because the major emphasis in our institute for last 20-25 years is on research and development. Teaching is our core activity, and we continue to do it with extreme passion and commitment, no doubt about it. But our R&D activities have really ramped up, and that is also reflected in the number of PhD students we have. Currently, we have about 3,000 PhD students in our institute. About 5 to 6 years ago, it was much less. Okay. And last year, August convocation, we awarded 325 PhD degrees. And about 2-3 years ago, we realized that the number of students who are graduating with PhD degree is so high, and they are not able to wait for the annual convocation. So in 2014, we started what is known as an interim convocation, primarily for PhD students. And this interim convocation is held during February of the year. Last month, February, we had 157 PhDs awarded just in the 6 months. So this is truly a reflection of the increased emphasis that our institute is placing on research and development activities. Okay. We also have actually sort of broadened our teaching programs. We had conventional and very classical traditional engineering disciplines as well as science disciplines, but now we also have other departments. One of the departments which is almost like 25-30 years old but very strong is our industrial design center. Professor Chakravarti is here. So we have a very active product development and industrial design center. We have several interdisciplinary programs on climate studies. Recently we started a center for policy studies. We have systems and controls. So there are many, many different types of interdisciplinary programs that we have. Okay. And in addition to the conventional departments, we also have about 20 to 25 very large scale project centers which are primarily focused on research activities. Okay. One example is National Center for Photovoltaic Research and Education. That is one of them. So several such we have, that being one of them. Center for Excellence in Nanoelectronics is there, and I don't know how many of you are actually taking benefit of that. There is something known as the Indian Nanoelectronic User Program, where the people in the across the country who are working in the area of nanoelectronics and nanotechnology can actually come here, use the facilities, and we sort of support their travel, stay, everything. Okay, that is also provided by the government, and I would like you people to make use of that and several other facilities. What also we have done is that last 6 years or so, our institute has sort of invested heavily in building up research infrastructure. We have spent close to about 180 crores in setting up very high-end research facilities. And in case you are not aware, these facilities are open to all of you. Okay, each and every engineering college in this country can make use of these facilities. You just have to sort of contact us. We will facilitate your usage. You don't have to be concerned about what happens. Okay, so in case you need any of these facilities, these are available on our website, and we can easily sort of make it available, but please do come and access these facilities and interact with us. We also have a center for continuing education and also the quality improvement program. The CEP program is something that is extremely active, and it sort of gives continuing education certification courses not only to teachers, engineering college teachers, but also to industries. Very many industries actually sort of approaches for the CEP courses. We design the CEP courses according to the college requirement or industry requirement. It can be 1 day, 1 week, 3 days. It can be at IIT Bombay, it can be in your own place. But please do let us know in case any such courses have to be conducted. IIT Bombay will be more than happy to conduct such courses. Okay. So I'll just give you some metrics as to how we are doing in terms of R&D. We actually have a technology business incubator, and it is about 15 years old as of now, and we have about 103 companies which have incubating, and about 30 of them have actually graduated, and few of them have already moved to Silicon Valley. And that business incubator is doing very well. In last few years, we see actually a very large number of youngsters who are not averse to taking risk, and they want to start up, startup companies and take their own inventions and ideas into companies. That is a very active program that we have, entrepreneurship. We have an entrepreneurship cell, which is completely run by the students. We also have SIGN, that is our technology business incubator. 2 years ago, we started what is known as entrepreneurship center, which is supported by one of our alumni, Desai City Center for Entrepreneurship. We offer minor programs. Students who are enrolled in BTech can actually take courses in this entrepreneurship cell and get a minors in entrepreneurship. And amazingly, in the first 2 years, we have about 5 to 6 inventions that have come from the center, and all the students have gone into a startup mode. Okay, so that is another thing that is very actively happening in our institute. And once again, any college of any of you who are interested in sort of starting this in your own institute, please let us know. We'll be more than happy to sort of support that. So this is just briefly some of the R&D activities that we have, and if you have any other questions or something, I will be more than happy to answer. And thank you very much.